Well, it's especially not me and Dad.
Go on that plane with a lot of people.
Sure.
When you talk music, it gets real personal real fast.
Sure,
that.
Sure.
So, yeah, kind of cheated.
Yeah, we didn't. We did cry.
Crying.
He recreated it for us.
Yeah.
Teenager, I was really hot for it. I hate to say it, like when the internet first came out and stuff, so you could just Google a lot of, you know, resources like you can now. And I was so passionate to learn what I could, and you just couldn't find it anywhere. And so a well-meaning friend of ours, who was actually a historian archaeologist type guy, friend of our family, who worked extensively in our Nisenan family tree, had told me with his best part of attention, he thought the language was extinct. And so now that we've been delving into the language, because there's resources, the linguists, back in the day when the linguists told everybody things and the archaeologists told everybody things, now it's changing where there really are these beautiful partnerships that are starting to blossom. I think enough generations have disappeared that the generations who are coming up in school now are going, wow, where are all the needs we want to learn from, and they're not there anymore, so they just have a real different take on things. And so the linguists are, we went to this thing called the Breath of Life in Washington, D.C., where we actually went into the Smithsonian Archives and the Library of Congress and saw these documents and these writings that we hadn't seen. Part of our project was to create the song. We've gone a couple times. One, the first time we went, we dissected and figured out what this old ancient song was saying that we would sing. We had really no idea what it was saying. And then on this time we went and we created a new song. So we kind of used the platform of the old ancient song. And when Daniel had said, could you share a traditional Nisenan song? You know, it's about the American River and that kind of thing. I did have a little bit of heart for me because songs belong to families and to people. And I mean, it's like the ultimate copyright back in the day. You didn't ever just go sing someone's songs because you would like sick and die and cause harm and havoc on your family. Very much so if you were gifted a song, it was a whole different thing. So I've gone through that a little bit, being a singer myself and wanting to sing and share our traditional things, and then finding a little bit of this juxtaposition of, it's really not appropriate to share some of those things without everybody, these key players, of permission. That are still alive and well in the family, and my mom and all my aunties and my cousins, who are sometimes very committed, which is good. I mean, you know, they want things how they want it, which is traditional. And so, so I had written this song. We came up with the words, all of us who were working in language, how to say the phrasing and everything, and then, but the tune, just, you know, when you're writing, it was just in my head, like, if the song was already written, I was just tuning into it. And so that's how that song came to be, and it's to actually, we're singing to the song, it just says, hear me sing, we want to visit, it's this old drum that's been in our family for hundreds of years, and it went missing, so without getting into too much details about all the pain and stuff around that topic.
We already shared.
Okay, good. So really it was the creating of the song to sing, because the drum is on its own path, doing its own thing, living its own life, and if it chooses to come back, it will. So maybe if we can entice it back, you know, maybe it'll come back. So the idea of sharing a modern Nisenan song in a contemporary setting, with contemporary, like with the dissonance and the stuff you guys just chilled me all over. It's so good. Like literally, itself through you guys, and I'm just so excited about that. So that's how that song came to be, and you know, again, it has its own life now, and as long as all the permissions are in place and everything, you know, my cousins following me around, Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. We are excited. Did you guys have any questions?
I'm always doing something with my voice, and I just sing it really straight. Okay.